Not that I'm complaining, but why have you brought me here on this glorious day to the historic seaside resort of Hastings, Gordon?
Well, Gary, this town's been booming since the reign of Queen Victoria. And towards the end of Queen Victoria's reign, the use of the telephone and the railway was really starting to get into full swing. Now, we're going to look at an innovation that also traces its roots back to the railway and the telephone era in the form of the rack.
The rack? What do you mean by the rack?
Well, what later became the 19-inch rack and now is standard across lots of industries, so that is also steeped in history, myth and legend, and we're going to find out about it in a factory that still makes them in Hastings to this day, and it's literally a stone's throw from here.
Someone's left a stone in here, Gary.
I wonder who did that.
Looks like it's from a beach.
I've got questions for you then, Gordon.
Okay, fire away.
So where historically have we used the rack?
Well, as I said in the introduction, this apparently has developed from either the rail industry, we're thinking rail signalling, or early telephone exchanges, where there was a need to mount electronics in a convenient place, and that's where racks first developed.
Okay, and we've all seen them, haven't we, in commercial installations, perhaps in that room where the hub is and the networking system, and they're massive, aren't they? These don't seem as big as the ones that we've perhaps come across before in the industry.
Yeah, I mean, you're thinking back to those days when it was the mainframe computer, Gary, with those revolving magnetic tapes, and that's where your mind's stuck, and people who worked in labs might think of all that electronic equipment. So the rack has stayed constant, but what we put in has changed significantly, and now home cinemas, you know, everyone has hubs for things. You know, you used to have electronics with dials on the front and screens. Now that tends to be wanting to be put out of sight, and you want one remote control.
So you're almost suggesting with the smart home revolution, we're going to see more of these perhaps in domestic installations.
Yeah, and that's where Penn Elcom have concentrated their efforts, their background in the AV industry, you know, building flight cases and speaker cables and things for speaker grills and all that things for the touring entertainment industry now arrived in the home, and that's what we're going to look at today, that specialism in the home AV rack system.
When we're talking about rack systems, I always hear 19 inches. Can you tell me what that is?
Yeah, it's the standard measurement of all racks. So if I run the tape measure across here between this module that fits into the rack, you'll see it's exactly 19 inches.
Yeah, so 19 inches being one. The next is the letter U.
Yeah, so the U is the height. So the racks are measured in modular heights, often referred to as U. So I've put this on here. This is a 1U, and that is exactly 1.75 inches.
How do I go about fitting the accessories within the rack then?
Okay, so here's a typical rack that we've got for an AV installation, and in there there's these two vertical bars that run down either side, and yes, they're just over 19 inches apart to fit our rack accessories, and we've got a choice. So traditionally this might have been a cage nut that you had to put your fixing into and then screw your accessory into, but now most people are going down the route of having a threaded bar at the front, which take in Europe we use a 6mm fastening, and then just screwed in to build up our rack.
An AV system has loads of cables, so how do I get them into the rack?
Okay, so this rack here we've got is designed for wall mounting, which gives us lots of options where we bring the cables in. We can start at the bottom here. There's a 1U sized removable panel.
Does the whole panel come out?
Yeah, the whole panel, so that's held by four screws. And that's then mirrored at the top of the cabinet. So this one's also can be used as a ventilation outlet, you know, should you decide not to bring the cables in that way. So again, that's 1U sized, held with the four screws.
Okay, anything around the back?
Yeah, so if you bring the cables in from the back, perhaps you've put them into the wall and you bring it out, there's the world's biggest cable knockout. Again, 1U sized, but you can see that's been pre-punched, ready to knock out. And then that's also mirrored at the bottom of the unit as well, where there's another one. While I'm there, these other holes here are for the wall mounting bracket. So weight, when you think about all this AV equipment, the weight can add up. So there's a substantial bracket that you can first fix to the wall first that hooks in. And again, if it's really heavy, that's mirrored at the bottom where there's another entry.
I noticed a bit of cable tray around the side here.
Yeah, it looks like cable tray. Yeah, that's the performance it's going to do. It's, yeah, to distribute the cables within the rack. So you've brought them in, and then it's a case of tidally bringing them to the correct level within the unit, so it's ready for the accessories that we'll look at next.
So So your first accessory looks to me like a power supply.
Yeah, so let's imagine we're going to build this rack to house a home audio system, home cinema, that games console. The first thing you need to worry about is power, Gary, and that's where this comes in, often known as a power distribution unit, or PDU. So in the simple man's terms, it's got switches on the front with neon indicators, and on the back it's got power outlets.
Oh, so we feed it in one position, but actually can feed multiple things like your DVD, your home surround system, etc.
Yeah, it's like a multi-plug, but with the advantage of a switch on the front, because that's the easiest way to reset a complex piece of equipment, Gary.
Turn it off and turn it back on again.
Yeah, sometimes the last resort, and that's where this comes in. So let's get this fitted to the rack.
Is that last M6 bolt going in?
Yeah, M6 in Europe, I think it's 1032s in America, whatever that is. And then we've got our one height, one U, PDU installed.
What's the next accessory you're going to put in for me?
Well, let's think we might have an amplifier, a home cinema receiver, so there's a nice shelf for that to sit on. Again, following the same principle, it drops in, and then we just put our M6 screws in.
It's almost everyone's favourite accessory, the next one, isn't it?
It is, yeah. Imagine you've put all this work into your wiring, you've carefully put the cables in, you want to put your name to the installation, and Penn Elcom give you two options for that, Gary. This is a laser-engraved aluminium panel, or you can have a full-colour printed panel, which is done with a UV printer. That is a great process, so yeah, let's fit. Which one do you want to go for, Gary?
I'd like to go for the white one, please.
You want the white one? So we'll fit that next. So hopefully that displays through the door when we fit it at the end.
This shelf looks a little bit different. It's got some vents in it.
Yeah, so shelves come in vented and non-vented options, depending on what you're putting in there, whether you want ventilation through. This one's a little bit different on a few different counts. It's got this little backstop. So this is really designed for equipment that may not have been intended originally to go on a rack. So think of that internet router. Think of that Sonos box. Think of the PlayStation. So that backstop can be adjusted so that the unit isn't pushed towards the back if, say, you're trying to operate the switches on the front, and you can also cable tie it through the ventilation slots as well. And then the other clever thing it has is this magnetic front panel that attaches to, so you end up with just the cutout for the piece of equipment you're going to be in there, so it keeps that rack up and neat and tidy.
Well, the rack is starting to take shape and it is looking lovely. What are you going to add to it now?
Well, I'm just going to finish that shelf we put in, Gary. Here's the custom panel that would sit nicely around our devices that we've installed in there. So maybe a Sonos box or an internet router or an Xbox. Obviously, this aperture would have to be cut out to suit accordingly.
I'm excited to find out what's going in next.
Well, it's this rather handy drawer, Gary. So think of all those things that you lose, instructions. And where do you want to put Mrs. H's Christmas present? This is the accessory for you, so let's get this fitted into the rack.
Rack's looking pretty full now.
Yeah, so now just fill up the blank spaces with these blank accessories. So again, we can put that in there. And then there's just one more thing to complete the look, Gary.
You've been patiently waiting to fit this one, so what have we got now?
Well, we want to pimp up our rack and show off our investment in technology. So this is a set of LED lights for the top of the rack, and I've set that to a nice eFIXX red.
So our rack still needs a few finishing touches.
Yeah, so the first thing is the side panels. Once we've finished our wiring, these just clip into place. And we need to fit the door. So again, the door can be either right or left-handed. It's just these little pull hinges. Do that, so you can sit it into place. Just close the door.
So we're building our rack up nicely. Of course, the items that go in there, I can see there's some holes in the top to aid with ventilation, but sometimes you need to increase that ventilation. Is there a way we can do that?
Yes, we've got a mechanical ventilation unit here. And there's, again, lots of options. You could put this in the rack.
And that's what this one's intended for, or?
On top of the rack. Mounts with the four screw holes around it. Another option would be to have open side panels, so slotted side panels to aid ventilation that way.
Well, there's a journey for me. I didn't know a lot about racks before we started this video, and now I know a lot more about it, and I'm falling slowly in love with the rack system as well.
Well, there's strong words from Gary. Now, this, Gary, is a wall-mounted version. Now, what we've found as we've been around the factory here is there are loads of options in terms of racks. Everyone has an opinion. If you've got your favourite way of doing something different to how we've shown, about ventilation, about lighting, about the branding. But Gary, there's just one more way of mounting a rack that can solve a problem for a lot of people.
Well, this looks very similar to the one you've just pulled me away from, but I'm sure it's got an added surprise.
Yeah, well, this one's been stripped down to its bare bones, Gary, but this is a secret rack.
Okay, a secret. I like a secret.
So you could hide this in a cupboard, but then you're thinking, you know, even the wall mount, well, what if I'm struggling to get my wires? I need to get the back of the unit. Watch this. Pulls out.
I like it.
And then you've got this tilt mechanism.
So if that was in a small cupboard, obviously the wiring system comes forward with it, you spin it round, you can do your work and push it back into place.
Yeah, and again, that cable tray feature, if you look at the back here, we've got this cable tray, so run your cables up. Careful with your bend radiuses, they go down underneath the unit, pop out in the middle, and then route it to your rack components. Oh, genius. So we're a stone's throw away from the beach. All the kit you've seen here is made in Hastings, and what's really impressed me is the amount of innovation I've seen as we go around adapting to the market, changes, and the needs of the AV installer, Gary.
And I've been taking a look at that process. Let's see that now. Well, he's been chasing me around his workshop all morning. It's my great pleasure to join by Rafa, who is the workshop manager here at Penn Elcom. Thank you for joining me.
Thank you.
I've been looking at these racks in particularly in your process. Can you describe what I saw out on your workshop floor?
Yes, of course. So we are starting from a raw steel, and then the beginning of the journey is punching machines as well as laser. That's where products are being either cut or punched. This then travels over to brake press department as well as panel benders. Once products are being and components are being shaped, we send them over to our powder coating line here in Hastings, and then they are being assembled here in Hastings.
Okay, that's Hastings, so it's in the UK. Do we export them worldwide?
Yes, we export them globally. We sell them to Europe as well as America. And there is a surge in demand, especially in Asia, over the last few months.
Okay, so typically, how many would you produce of, say, these two in a month?
It's about 500 units a month currently.
Okay, and how many parts would I have maybe manufactured back there for these racks?
So we can customize depending to what you require. But generally speaking, we produce around 180,000 components a month.
Wow, that's why I saw so many processes going on in your factory. Now, you know, times have been difficult recently. Have you seen your growth figures of these racks increase or decrease recently?
Yes, over the past 12 months, there's a massive surge in the demand for this type of a product.
Okay, what do you think's caused that demand?
I think it's just driven by the current circumstances where people are being forced to work from home.
Yeah, that makes sense, doesn't it? All of a sudden yes. Now, our reliability of internet, maybe sound, home cinema systems becoming a lot more important to people who are spending a lot more time at home.
Yes, people are looking to secure their goods safely on their premises.
Wow, that'll be some impressive kit in that factory, Gary. Significant investment, I think.
Yeah, and it was a pleasure to spend some time with Raf walking around that.
Yeah, while Gary was doing that, I was checking out the LED strip assembly service from Penn Elcom. So check out that video.
Eye above my head, link in the description below, no doubt.
It certainly is. And in our next video, we're going to look at this cabinet behind us, which is a half-depth rack cabinet and is ideally suited to home network installation. We've looked at that on the channel before, but we think this is another fantastic solution.
We've had a fantastic time down here in Hastings. If you've got any comments, please leave them below and we'll try and get back to, as always, as many as we can.